back to my class. As you know that I'm Halima Nisa, teacher and junior lecturer of Alibeth High School and Junior College. So in today's class, we will discuss about the chapter 4 from inter-first year subject civics and named as political concepts. Here now about the justice. We have learned what are the law, liberty and equality. Exactly. So justice represent a synthesis of all these concepts. Here justice is the thread which runs through all these values and make them a parts of an integrated as a whole. So here with the emergence of democracy and socialism, the concept of justice has truly been transformed. Exactly. So it has given a way to the concept of social justice. Here the social justice is the voice of the oppressed and underprivileged against the oppressed and the exploitative practices. Getting here. So here the justice is the contemporary world is concerned with determining logical criteria for the allocation of goods, services, opportunities, benefits, power and honors, as well the obligations in the society, particularly in the scarcity situations. Okay, meaning and definitions of justice. Here the word justice is derived from the Latin word that is jus, and also including the justus or the justitia. Here means something, primarily a joining or fitting a bond or the tie. Here the gilding into a sense of bonding or the obliging. Getting here. So the primary, the joining or fitting implied in the idea of justice is that the bond between the man and man in an organized system of human relations. Get it here. So it means that a body of binding and obliging rules which are recognized and enforced the state. Here the term justice implies the quality of being just, means right or reasonable. Okay, it is opposed to what is unjust, wrong or unreasonable. Okay, this is the meaning of justice. So here some are the definitions of justice. See this. So after meaning and definitions of the justice, now we will see the major concepts of justice. Here the concept of justice has been put forth and elaborated by different theories of justice. Exactly. So here broadly they are categorized into three, and they are the Greek, Stoics and the Roman concept of justice, and then the modern theory of justice, and then the contemporary theories of justice. So we will see in detail about all these justice. First we will go with the Greek and the Stoics and the Roman concepts of justice. Here the Plato laid the foundation of the justice, and the virtue is the core value of the Platonic justice. Here the virtue is consist in the discharge of duty by every individual without interfering into the other's duties. Getting here. So for Aristotle, the law is complete virtue. Here the Aristotle regards justice as a complete virtue, and according to the Stoics, here the justice could be discovered by the reason and was superior to the positive law, that is law made by state. Whereas according to the Romans, justice is associated with the law only. Okay, so come to the modern theory of justice. Is that here the modern theory of justice emerged with the social contact theories of Hobbes, Locke and Rochelle also. After the movements of reformation and renaissance and the industrial revolutions, here Hobbes identified the justice with the absolute sovereignty of the state. So here Locke, whereas the Locke identified the justice with the natural rights, and where and other side the Rochelle, he is identify the justice with the general view only. Getting here. So after the modern theories of justice, now we will see about the contemporary theories of justice. In these theories are focused on the distinction between the substantial justice and procedural justice. Here the procedural justice treats the rules of market economy as the model rule of human behavior, whereas the freedom of contract is the mainstay of the procedural justice. In this, so it is the justice procedure than its outcome which automatically is accepted as just as F.A. Hayek and the Milton Friedman and the Robert Ware is its main components. Okay, here the procedural justice repudiates the all discriminations and the accepts equal dignity and moral worth of all the human beings. Okay, after the contemporary theories of justice, now we will discuss about here the types of justice. There are different type of justice, and they are legal justice, political justice, economic justice and social justice. Now we will see in detail about all these justice. So first we will go with the legal justice. The legal justice is manifest in the law of the state and it is supplemented by customs of the society. So it is embodied in the constitution and the legislative enactments in a state, and it determines the legal contours of justice here. Here the legal justice is basically has two importance. Firstly, it implies that there is a just application of the law in the society on the basis of the rule of law. There will be no discrimination between the individuals in the application of law. The law are made in the consensus with the principles of the natural justice. Okay, that is on no bias and the right to fair hearing. Okay, now come to the political justice. Here in political justice, that it symbolizes the political equality and establishment of a democratic order without any discrimination exactly. So it implies the provision of the political rights to all the adult citizens in a state, and also it facilitates the free and the fair participation of the citizens in the governance of the country exactly. And it is also manifested to the full extent of time of election, and it also allows the citizens for their active participation in day-to-day administration. Get it? This is the political justice. Now come to the economic justice. Economic justice, when we refers to the economic justice, it refers to the equitable distribution of commodities and reordering the human relations in the economic sphere exactly, and that is relationship between the employer and worker, and trader and consumer, and landlord and tenant, and relationship between the money lender and the borrower, etc. All these are the relationship, economic relationship of this. Okay, so as to eliminate the exploitation of man by man and especially the vulnerable sections of society, it stands for the equal treatment of individual irrespective of differences in the income, money, wealth, property, etc. So it is in a positive aspect. It implies payment of adequate to the workers and reducing the disparities in the distribution of wealth and incomes. Get it? This is the economic justice. Now we will see that after economic justice, now we will see the social justice. The term social justice implies a just social order of the privileges based on birth, race, caste, creed or sex. So here social justice implies a reordering of social life in such a manner that the material and moral benefits of social efforts are not considered by a tiny privileged classes. Get it? But accords to the masses to ensure the uplift of the lower, weaker and underprivileged sections of the society. So it ensured the eradications of the social evils like poverty, unemployment, starvation, diseases, etc. All these. And here it also the social justice includes the economic justice, and also to restore the dignity of human beings who have lost it due to the lower economic and educational and cultural status. Get it? This is the social justice. Here the Indian constitution, which come into the effort in 1950, is particularly its preamble and the fourth part dealing with the directive principles of state policy is committed with the deal of social justice only, that is the social, economic and political. Get it? This is the social justice. Now after the justice term, we will discuss about the power and authority. Here the concept of power has become the key concept covering all the aspects of Politics, exactly. If the politics as a process of the resolution of the conflict, the distribution of powers within the political community determines how the conflict is to be resolved. Whether the resolution is to be effectively accepted by all the parties. So here the influence with the willing acceptance or the legitimacy implies the authority power. So here the power to be active and the stable must be accompanied by the capacity to secure the willing obedience here. Exactly. So after this, now we will see about the meaning and definition of power. Here the power denotes the ability of a person to fulfill his desire and to achieve his objectives. Exactly. Here power is a relationship in which one person or group is able to determine the actions of another in the direction of the former's end. Okay, here the sum of the definitions are here. Just see this. After seeing these definitions, here the chief characteristics, features of power is that it is one-sided and shows a kind of influence exercised by the man or a group over an unwilling lot of power. Here power to be effective and stable must be accompanied by the capacity to secure the willing obedience. So therefore it often takes the character of authority, which inherently connotes a kind of legitimacy. After this meaning and definitions of the power, now we will see the nature and significance of power. Here in the nature and the significance of power, that the what the concept of power for the politics is the money to the subject of economics. Exactly. With the emergence of the concept of powers as focus of study, political science gained in an independent status as against in earlier status. Okay, here the study of philosophy or history or law or ethics, all the exponents of the power view of politics focus on the study of the acquisition and the maintenance and the loss of power only. Okay, get it. So here during the early phase of development of modern political science, it was felt that the proper scope of political science was not just the study of state or any other formal institutions, but it was an informal organ which have got a lot of influence, that is power in the state only. Get it. So with the inclusion of both formal and the informal political organizations, here the political science has become a study of modern political dynamic and expanded its scope. Get it? Exactly. After this, nature and significance of power, now we will see the power and authority. Here after the power and authority, now authority. Here authority consists of two important aspects, that is power and legitimacy. Here the legitimacy of an act or arrangement that implies the members of society and treat that act or arrangement as a beneficial to society as well as to themselves also. Getting here. So here authority is the most effective instrument of exercising the power in the sphere of politics. Exactly. So here the power relations in the society must be expressed in terms of command, and also if command is based on genuine motivation, it may result in a willing obedience. Exactly. So here if the command is based on the threat of punishment or the obedience come from fear, and the power relation takes the form of tyranny, which would eventually lead to rebellion. Exactly. That the legitimacy, willing acceptance, or what is known as the authority is the best instrument to ensure the effective and the enduring use of power only. Exactly. So after this power and authority, now we will discuss about different forms of power. So here different forms of powers, and they are political power, technological power, economic power, ideological power, and the national power. Now we will discuss about all these in detail. First we will go with the political power. Here the political power refers to the influence exercised by the formal and informal organs of the state. So here power in politics is always political power, and the power of the state and the power of the government and the power of the laws through which the government operates. But these formal organs. In turn, they are influenced by the informal organs, which are not only taken the form of the political parties in power and in position, but also the large number of pressure groups and public opinions and the popular movements, mass media, etc. are there. So this comprehensive analysis of powers goes beyond the formal organs of the state and includes the informal organs of the state. Get it? This is political power. Now come to the technological power. Technological power. Here the technology in modern times has become a very important and essential element in the exercise of power. Exactly, we know this very well. So in recent times, the dawn of intelligent machines in the form of artificial intelligence, that is AI revolution, will have the immense influence on man, society and politics also. Here the computers and unintelligent machines are already doing much of the work in contemporary democracies. Exactly. So the political parties rely on the large automated database to help run their campaigns. Exactly. Here the government increasingly utilizing the big data system to manage the deliver health care and the other public services also. So this is a technological power. Now come to the economic power. When we come to the economic power, is the power derived from the possession of wealth and especially the major means of production and distribution also. So here the economic power plays a vital and the important role in the decision making process in the liberal democracies. Exactly. If a nation is possesses the abundant natural and the other resources, then it will have more economic powers. Exactly. This is the economic power of one nation or a state. Now come to the ideological power. Ideological power represents the manipulative power of the dominant and the ruling classes, which hold the way of thinking and emotions of the people and try to create illusion of the consent here. So the people are led to believe that they are governed with their approval, while they are actually continued to be the governed according to the design of the ruling classes. Exactly. So here this is ideological powers. Now come to the national power. X is a struggle for power. Exactly. Here, whatever may be the ultimate aims of the international politics, here power is an immediate aim. So in this context of international relations, the national power implies the seven states and attempt to the influence of other seven states in the term of achieving its own goals in international affairs. Get it here? So here the authority is the complaints by one nation to the directives issued by the another nation is measured by the perception of respect, solidarity, affection and the affinity and the leadership, knowledge and expertise. Get it? So here, as the against of the conventional theories of power, which primarily concern with the power over, that is power, here power is of the dominant and over means here the dependent. But in modern perspectives, instead of this concept of power to, that means, that is power means of the dependent, and to here is achieve a goal of his own choice. Getting here? Here the empowerment of the vulnerable sections, like for example empowerment of women and of the ordinary people, and the implies of the equipping them with the power to ease resist their oppressors and gain an opportunity and availability to utilize their capacities for self-dependent. Get it? So here by this we have completed our fourth chapter, that is political concept. By this concept we have understand the traditional one, as it implies a shift in the focus from the formal organizations to informal one. Exactly. Then we are no longer confining our focus of learning in the political science as to who rules a country according to its constitution, but we have to move the focus further in the political science and identify the groups and the classes which actually wield the power for the deeper understanding of the politics and the necessities of distribution of power equally to all the groups and the classes for establishing A. True democratic society or true democratic state. Get it? Thank you.